Today, we're going to talk a little bit about what do you get in a carton when you buy an Emlid RS2. We have a lot of people that buy these receivers and they want to know what they're going to get exactly. So we'll have a look inside the box, we'll see what is there, and then we'll go through the process of updating your RS2 so it's ready to use in the field. When we open it up, you can see inside the front cover, there are some instructions on the app that you need to download, the process that you need to go through to connect to the Wi-Fi network, and then how to open the app. And then there's a QR code that allows you to access all of the videos and tutorials that Emlid have helpfully published on their website. When we go a little further into the box, we have the case that contains the RS2. And I've got to say, pretty much, like most surveyors around the country, the first thing that goes in the bin is the box. Our RS2s pretty much live in this receiver and they get thrown around the ute and they do pretty well just in those containers. And if we look inside the box itself, there's a user guide that supports your quick use of the receiver, and there's also some stickers that allow you to identify if you've bought a couple of them. They've got base and rover stickers, so you can put the base and rover stickers on your relative receivers so you know which one's your base and which one's your rover as you continue working. Further down in the box, there's another little hatch that we can open, and when we pull out that little cover, underneath that little cover, the shoulder strap cover, is a neat little shoulder strap. To be honest, we don't really use these in our company, but some people do, and so it allows you to connect a shoulder strap to either side of your receiver. So obviously you can throw it over your shoulder and carry it through the field, freeing up your hands. So putting the box and the instructions to one side, let's open up the RS2 receiver case and have a look at what's inside. So there's our brand new Emlid Reach RS2 receiver. And you can see that it's got rubber flaps to cover the LoRa and USB ports, and also to cover the serial port, the LiMo port that allows you to connect power and to support data in and out. And there's also a cover for your SIM slot where you can connect your SIM card to the receiver to allow it to consume end-trip corrections directly from the internet. Now, interestingly, these rubber covers aren't what provide the IP67 rating. The device is IP67 rated, so you can use it, you know, in dusty and wet conditions with these flaps open. These flaps simply exist to keep those ports clean, to keep the dust and the mud and the insects out of them. So you can use it with these open in the rain with confidence. So aside from our receiver, we also have tucked into the lid a antenna. Now, one of the first things that we do is put a bright coloured sticker on our antennas, because if you drop that in the grass and, you know, it's a dark day or, you know, it's a long grass, it can be a bit hard to find. So it is a good idea to put something colourful on that so that you don't lose it. And tucked away in the corner of the case is a USB-A to USB-C cable to charge your device. The first thing you'll notice when you pull your unit out and you go to start it up is that it's very likely to be quite flat. A single short duration press on the power button brings up the battery level indicator. And this one, as you can see, has a single orange light. It will have a string of white LEDs to the right of that if it is fully charged. So when you're planning to grab your RS2 from the post office, or it's the courier's dropped it off and you want to take it out in the field, make sure that you've planned enough time to be able to charge your receiver up. And on the topic of charging, the Emlid comes with a USB cable that is designed specifically for charging this. I've seen reports online, and in fact I've helped people on some of the Facebook user groups, where they've indicated that their unit just isn't charging. It's dead flat and it's not charging. And the root cause almost always seems to be that they're using an inferior quality USB cable. So if you use the cable that's provided by Emlid or another high quality thick USB cable, you should avoid the problems of your RS2 unit not charging. So we've charged up our RS2 to about the halfway point. And as you can see, it's got three consecutive white LEDs. A long press on the power button will invoke the boot sequence for the device. Now, if you have run your device down to flat or left it in storage and it's gone flat, it is a good idea to make sure that you give it plenty of time to get a good charge. If it's completely flat, I often recommend it's a good idea, if you've got the time, to leave it on charge for a solid 48-hour period. There are two reasons for that. One, The intelligence in the battery management of the Emlid receivers starts with a trickle charge and then gradually increases the power coming into the battery over time. So if it's completely flat and you leave it connected, for the first few hours it's really not receiving much charge. And when you boot it up, it's quite power hungry. That's when it uses the most power during the operation of the receiver. So you need to make sure that you've charged the battery enough that it's going to get through that boot sequence. The combination of not having it on charge for long and trying to boot it up will often deplete an incompletely charged battery if it's, you know, only got a small amount of charge in it. So you can see the battery indicator lights have stopped scrolling, which indicates that the boot sequence has completed and the device has now created its own Wi-Fi hotspot. You can see that it's in Wi-Fi hotspot mode because the Wi-Fi LED indicator is white. So we're now going to pop down the receiver, grab our iPad, head into the Wi-Fi settings, and we're going to search for our Reach Wi-Fi hotspot. And you can see it there in our list of available networks. So now we're going to type in that factory default password, Emlid Reach, lowercase, all one word. It's going to go through and seek to connect. It's been able to connect and join to that Reach Wi-Fi hotspot. So now we can go to our Reach software and you can search the receivers, and certainly it's found our Reach. Interesting thing, when they're in hotspot mode, they always have the same IP address, 192.168.42.1. You can't use the Reachview3 app on your laptop, but you can load in that IP address and it will load the old Reachview2 software on your laptop. So if you prefer to do this on your laptop, it is still possible there. But I don't know if that will always be the case in the future. So you can see that it's recognized that this is a new receiver that needs to be set up to prepare it for work. So we need to click on that Setup Reach link, and it's going to open up the Reach firmware updater, and it's going to run some tests, and then it's going to prompt us to join a known Wi-Fi network. So now I need to come in here and add the relevant Wi-Fi network. All right, so we're going to connect it to Man Goes Mapping 1, and that is the correct security type for our network, and now we're going to enter the password. So while it's seeking to join the Mango's Mapping 1 Wi-Fi network, you can see that the it's successfully joined because it stopped flashing. While it's trying to join another network, it'll flash blue, and once that Wi-Fi indicator goes to a solid blue, that's telling you that it is successfully connected to the network that you were trying to establish. It's really easy to make a typo when you're putting in your Wi-Fi network password. So we have a lot of people that contact us and go, it's not connecting, it doesn't successfully connect to my Wi-Fi password, what's wrong with the receiver? And when we debug it with people, it's inevitably that they've had trouble getting the Wi-Fi password correct as they're typing it in. And there's not an opportunity for you to see the Wi-Fi password as you type it in. And if you have that trouble, you need to go back into your updater software and delete the known Wi-Fi network that you've just created and have another crack at recreating it and you know, be very diligent about the way that you enter your Wi-Fi password. So we can now come in here. We're connected to Mango's Mapping 1. And the receiver is also connected to Mango's Mapping 1. So when we go to our Reachview 3 software, if we just shut down and restart that app, it will search again for the available receivers. And you can see that the receiver is now available and it has a different IP address. Again, because we haven't completed preparing it for work, it's going to take us back into the setup process. So we press Setup Reach, it takes us back into the updater, and it's now prompting us for a Reach name. We will leave that as Reach, I'll put in Reach MGM for this one. Return, get rid of my keyboard, and then hit save. So it's now going to have a unique name out of our fleet of Reach RS2 devices. And it's going through now, and it's going to have a different set of processes that includes confirming that the firmware is up to date. Now this one, we've just reflashed this one to demonstrate for you this updater process. With yours, it may well need to update the firmware, and that's a reasonably large data package that it'll seek to download, so it can take quite a few minutes for it to download that large file and to run the installer. So this one's now ready to work, so we can go back out of updater and select that receiver from the list, and now we're ready to go in and configure this Reach RS2 receiver for work. So today we've unboxed the Reach RS2 and shown you all of the contents that you will receive when you order a receiver from Mango's Mapping. Of course, the receivers are a lot easier to use if you have a survey polder mounted on, a bipod to keep that steady, and if you're using a base, tripods, tri-brack adapters, and the like. Head to our website to learn more about the accessories that you can use with your Emlid Reach RS2. Thanks for joining us today. See you in the next video.